It like resonates like almost like a reverb inside there.
Yeah, there's. Anyways, so we got two brand new Pepe B6s. This is the six string baritone, and it's a very versatile instrument. This is built off, well, built to be like this, like a mini flamenco guitar that he produces. He produces like the full size flamenco guitars, which are phenomenal. This is based off of that design. It has the flamenco pick guards here. You know, a lot of the players, they do a lot of percussiveness with the strumming and picking. This will keep that top protected. As far as like the design, he basically took his flamenco guitar, kind of shrunk it down, so you still get this very full bass tones that you don't usually hear out of an instrument this size. The action is really low, and the sustain is very good all the way up the neck. And all the overtones you get when you're playing whatever notes that overlap. Playing really soft, and it just speaks. Not speaks, it sings. But this is the 19 inch. This is the 19 inch version. So it's like a 19 inch super tenor scale, or the old 19 inch baritone scale. Gives you a lot of room to play guitar chords or whatever you need to do. We currently have it tuned G to G, and I feel that this might be the best range for the instrument. It gives you really good sustain. The string tension is perfect at this pitch, and Listen to that. Anyways, this is, like I was saying, 19-inch scale, tuned G to G. This is with Pepe's UG1 guitar lele, or Guilele set. If you want to tune E to E, standard guitar tuning, he makes another set. It's the UG2 set, and the diameter is a little thicker to allow you to tune to the lower notes. Or you could even do it with this. You'll get lower tension, but you might sacrifice some sustain and some of those overtones. But it's very, very versatile, different tunings. Can you tune up to A to A at all with any string set? Yeah, because this in G to G tuning, this seems already tight.
Perfect.
On the the action is really low, which is great. Anyways, wow. So the woods on here, this is a European spruce, one of the famous types of spruce tops used on string instruments. Very, very clear, responsive sound. And that's kind of, I'm not kind of, that's what's really driving the top on this instrument. The back and sides, this is Spanish cypress. And the overall instrument, usually with larger instruments, you kind of expect it to be heavier. This is a featherweight instrument. Very, very, very light, very well balanced. Has Goto tuners, the planetary tuners that you find on ukuleles and stuff. Very, very smooth. Works very well in this configuration. Top and back binding, ebony. Like I was saying, Spanish cypress back and sides kind of reminds me of kind of like a maple as far as like the look. And I got this nice back strip down here. It was a Spanish heel. And this is a hand polish, French polish, which is, very time consuming, but allows for the most resonant instrument, and that's exactly what you get with Pepe's. Never fail. You get such an open sound. Wow. The way it hits all these bass notes, you wouldn't expect it to sound like that. Whatever you throw at this instrument is, oh. Anyways. Yeah, so this is the UG1 Guilele set. The bottom three are fluorocarbon strings, the top are wound strings like what you'd find on a classical guitar. And beautiful, fantastic as always. Get it while it lasts. This is one thing I forgot to mention. It's 12th fret to the body, and that changes the bridge placement. Usually gives you a warmer sound, and that's what you hear a lot in this. Let's sit and figure out what I'm gonna play. Here. So, I was, or used to be, a classical guitar player back at the University of Hawaii for about 2 years. So don't mind my sloppiness and not doing, you know, hovering and stuff. But I had a classical guitar back in college that I got rid of. But this guitar is about half the size of that, yet the sound is so much better, so much more projection. The overtones are crazy, you know, on this. The articulation is just... just sings. I mean, whenever I play an instrument, I always look for good articulation, good sustain, good resonance, and this guitar encompasses all of that. So, super easy to play, sounds really full, it feels really good to play. like holding it because just it fits in my hand. I don't really like holding guitars that are like this big, and I have to put my whole arm around it to hug it, but it just feels really good to play, to hold. It sounds really good. The action's really low, but it doesn't buzz. So this is a very great little guitar. So
okay. But man, there's so much air and just like beautiful crisp tones.
It's funny when you said air and I was like, wait, this no, this isn't air. It is air, yeah.
What? It's ambiance.
That sound good?
Yeah. So talk about the woods and stuff, and then
so number 324. This is the little Pepe, the second one that we got, and I think this is the first one that we had with the sunburst, which is nice. It's like a vintage sunburst, and same thing. This is based off his flamenco guitar design, just shrunken down. You still get that real nice guitar sound. Sorry, it's a guitar. But, yeah. Anyways, got ebony binding top and back. And this Italian maple back and sides, it's a wood known for having excellent resonance. It's used in, you know, classical guitars and, you know, other instruments. But yeah, very good tone. Forgot to mention the bracing that he uses. So it doesn't have your traditional fan bracing or, you know, X bracing. Yeah, I mean, you never use X bracing on these kind of guitars. You got two transverse braces, mahogany here, but he uses his skin bracing. It's a layer of spruce. It's graduated spruce on the top, and it's it covers the entire top of the soundboard here. And there's no other, like I was saying, no other bracings in here besides that, the two bars here and that skin brace in here. The back bracing, if you look inside, there's no bars. It's a rosewood brace that continues from the top of the instrument all the way to the bottom. It's pretty interesting how it all works. But yeah, that all, everything contributes to a fantastic sounding instrument, and that's what you get with this thing. Beautiful custom supermodel coil tenor from one of our favorite custom builders, from Pepe Romero. So we got tenor size ukulele here, all Hawaiian curly coil in the front, sides and back. It's really pretty. We got a Florentine cutaway. We got ebony, what's it called again?
Bevel,
yeah. We got an ebony bevel. And what's cool about this bevel is that it wraps around the whole entire ukulele rather than just where you place your arm. So it looks really cool. Got a nice little rosette over here. We got rosewood bridge, rosewood fretboard. We got Godel tuners. And is this a rosewood faceplate too? We got rosewood faceplate. And we have the sound port on the side. To me, this sounds like a classical ukulele, how classical guitars have a nice, big, warm sound with nice articulation. It's not bright, but it has a really sweet tone. So this ukulele encompasses all of that. And for me, I love playing with that kind of sound. So give it a listen. It's really fun to play. I mean, it's nice because I can really milk all these notes. You can really hear the vibration when you it just goes on. So when you have that much control and leeway with the kind of notes that ring,
it really changes the way you want to approach your playing, because, you know, when you play some ukuleles and let's say the note dies out fast, you kind of have to compensate for that by playing faster, or you have to rush through the notes. Whereas when you hear this kind of sound, it almost wants to breathe, and you want to give it, you know, do it justice and just let it. I just want to let it breathe and just keep the sustain going. So it really changes my playing and how I'm going to approach playing any kind of arrangements or playing songs. So.
Because you can always shorten your sustain.
Yeah, exactly. But if the ukulele doesn't have it, then you have nothing to work with. Then you just have to force your way through it. But this ukulele just lets you have a lot of options with your playing. So I really like it.
Especially with these, like, you just
want to play it.
I don't have to. I just have to instrument do the talking. Yeah. Anyways, before I wander into
the dumb.
Yeah, I have to talk about this spectacular instrument. This is the first of this style. You never really see. Pepe's instruments with Florentine cutaways, but now you have today. We just got these, and it's an all-core instrument, top, back, and sides. Beautiful core, by the way. And what you'd expect from a Pepe Romero instrument, just greatness. And it has a really cool arm bevel, ebony, smooth. Super smooth, allows for long sessions of beautiful ukulele playing. Side port here. This is something you don't see on his instruments either, but it adds to the overall airiness to the instrument. You can hear the instrument just breathe when you play one chord. It's just sound just coming out of here and here. String through bridge. These are strung from the inside of the instrument, so unlike the regular classical style bridge where you tie it, this you stick the string through, tie a knot, pull it through, and then string it up as you do normally. One thing forgot to mention, all the instruments that we just got have a slight radius to them, so you don't really notice it until you look at the saddle and you're like, oh, it's rounded, and the fretboard is a slight curve to it. It's always beneficial to players who like to do bar chords or, you know. This instrument also has the skin bracing. It's spruce on the top and back. What the skin bracing is a very thin piece of wood. Instead of the traditional bracing that you see in instruments with the fan bracings, three fans, or X bracing, this only has two transverse braces up here, and then very thin layer around the bottom of the soundboard. And there's, you know, that also takes place of the bridge plate. The strings sit directly on the skin bracing, and it changes up the tone. I feel like where Pepe is saying it gives it more of a balanced sound, but an open sound. That's exactly what I hear in these instruments. All of that probably contributes to that amazing sound you get from this thing. Like how Mika was mentioning earlier, every note you're able to milk it because it has really good sustain. Every note has very good presence. Every single note on this. Generally, you don't even play up here, but all the playable notes up here, they come up very, very clear. It's very impressive. Yeah. Crazy. Florentine cutaway allows you to access all those notes up there. These come strung with the low G Pepe Romero tenor string set. This is a smooth wound gold string, very quiet, and offers a really, really good full but balanced sound. The plain strings are fluorocarbon. That's really good clarity, especially on this instrument. Good old trusty Goto UPT tuners. Rosewood bridge, fretboard, and faceplate. Yeah, all the goodies. French polish on all these instruments, so ensure the maximum resonance possible. It's very, very light finish. Very pretty glossy too. Just nice. If you look in the light and stuff, you can see the depth of curl and whatnot. Oh, anyways.